Dear servant of God, I am Robert Simon. Beloved in Christ, faith is the substance of the things hoped for and the evidence of the things not seen. In my last talk with you, I did say that faith is not positive thinking. There is no connection whatsoever between faith and positive thinking. In an example, we saw how faith works. When a child of God walks through a gorge under the shadow of death, he knows for certainty, with no shadow of doubt, that God is with him. He has the conviction, the evidence, that God is with him, though he doesn't see God, not necessarily even to feel the presence of God. We finished with this question: how does one get that substance, the substance called faith? In Romans 10:17, we read, "Faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God, and hearing by the word of God." We shall try to understand what this verse says. We should read this verse carefully to get exactly what it means. Familiarity breeds contempt, Shakespeare says. Now please listen. Faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Faith doesn't come to a person simply because he or she hears the gospel or God's word preached to him or her. Faith comes by hearing, and that hearing must be by the word of God. In other words, it is because of the work of that word itself the hearing comes. That hearing brings faith in us, not simple hearing with our mortal ears. Let me try to explain this with a very simple example. In a class, all the students know the word stand, S-T-A-N-D. The teacher uses the word stand many a time in the course of her teaching a lesson. At the close of her class, to make her pupils stand, the teacher says in an imperative mood and tone, "Stand." And now the hearing of the word stand of the teacher makes the class stand. It means when the spirit and power in a word is released, a hearing comes, and that hearing of that word causes action in us, and not just because our ear hears a word. Now in the book of Revelation, we read again and again this statement, "He that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit saith unto the churches." We, hence, understand when we hear what the Holy Spirit tells us, or what the word of God spoken or written tells us, and that hearing caused by the word will bring faith. Amen. I will, God willing, be continuing on faith in my next talk with you also. Till then, God bless you, God be with you. I am yours, Robert Simon.